This tutorial is about physical sun and sky and Maya. It's the closest thing we've got to the make cool button. All right, here's my scene in Maya. First thing that I'm gonna do is to go to my render settings. So I'll just click my render settings button. I do wanna double check, make sure that mental ray is turned on, and then I'm gonna go into the indirect lighting tab. And physical sun and sky is right up at the top. I'm just gonna click the create button. And we'll see two things have popped up. We've got a new physical sky node and also a sun direction node. Let's talk about the sun direction first. It's actually a directional light. So I can go into my outliner or find it in the scene, and I just like to scale it up so that it's easier to find when I want to start interacting with it. But hey, the second we hit that create button, physical sun and sky is active, so we re-render and we see what we've got. Our scene is much, much brighter. In fact, it's too bright, it's washed out, so we're gonna need to make some adjustments. We need to go to our viewport view menu and then select the camera and scroll down to find the mental ray tab. And what we're looking for is a lens shader. Physical sun and sky plugs in an exposure node to our lens shader. We always have to keep that in mind. So I'm going to click on the little black arrow next to it and make some changes to it. So I need to adjust my exposure parameters to take my scene, which is currently washed out, to having a better level of contrast. But the parameters in here, they don't exactly spell out what they do. We start with the gain parameter. And gain is just the overall brightness. If I lower the gain, my scene gets darker. If I raise the gain, it gets brighter. So by setting it to 0.125, I can see that I get a scene that's a little bit less washed out. But generally, we don't want to just linearly adjust the gain down or up. We want to adjust other parameters like pedestal to increase contrast. So pedestal affects the darks, the blacks in our scene. And by lowering the pedestal, I can make my blacks much, much darker so that I'm creating a crushed black look. And this is a good start. It makes my scene more contrasty. It actually might make it a little bit too contrasty. So I'll just raise the pedestal a little bit to kind of bring some light back into those shadows. And then I'm gonna turn my attention back to the gain. I'm gonna raise the gain slightly to 0.15. That will brighten the overall scene as a whole, but because of my darker blacks, I'll still maintain a good level of contrast. So a quick review, I lowered the gain to darken the scene as a whole. I lowered the pedestal to make my shadows a little bit darker and more contrasty. Now let's turn our attention back to the sun direction light. I'm going to rotate that, and by rotating it, that changes the position of the sun in the sky, and this is pretty cool. It's a really easy way to change the look of our scene. We can see I rotated my sun. The sun is now lower in the sky and I get longer shadows. But now what's really cool is physical sun and sky creates time of day effects based on the position of our sun in the sky. So I've created a sunset effect here. We'll see that the colors are more orange, the way that they would be during sunset. And if we look at the sky, we'll see that the sky that's been created has a sunset look. The light is getting oranger as it gets closer to the horizon. So this is the really cool part about physical sun and sky, but let's check out some other attributes. If I go into my render settings and I go to the physical sun and sky, I can just click that black arrow to open up my physical sky parameters. And I'm going to rotate my sun back to an afternoon pose and re-render. Now let's look at these parameters. Some of them, like the horizon height, are pretty self-explanatory. It just controls that gray line back there. Red-blue shift is where I like to start. Red-blue shift controls the warmness or the coolness of my scene. And it's on a scale from -1 being blue to 1 being red. It would be really useful to have a slider here, but no, Maya loves it when we have to do things the hard way. So if I adjust my scene to a -1, I'll see that my entire scene is very blue and way too blue. Probably only appropriate for something like an underwater scene. Generally, we're only going to use values of like -0.3 or -0.2. And when I re-render here, now I get a much cooler scene. So I'm trying to create a late afternoon look. Now, if I switch it in the other direction, 0.2 or 0.3, I'll get a much warmer look, something that's appropriate for a much hotter day or a desert environment or something like that. So red-blue shift allows us to very quickly control the overall look of our entire scene. Next up is haze, which creates overcast. So haze is on a scale of 0 to 10. We put it up to 10 and haze covers the sky. We'll see that our shadows get a little bit more diffused and by default, it's a little bit too yellow. We're always going to use some blue shift with Haze to create more of a natural overcast look. Haze does max out at 10, but if I set it to 100... Anyways, other effects. How about saturation? If we set this down to 0, we can remove saturation in our scene, and we get a black and white image that doesn't look like natural sunlight, but it does look like a cool artistic effect that we could use to create, for example, a really depressing city or an alien planet or something like that. So let's tilt our sun back to more of a sunset or sunrise position. We can actually see the sun up in the sky, and that's where these sun parameters come in. So the sun disk scale or the sun intensity. I'm going to adjust those, and I'm going to increase the size of the sun and the intensity so that I get a huge sun in the sky, which is appropriate if the sun has just gone supernova or I'm on an alien planet. But take note that that doesn't affect the intensity of the light at all. That's where multiplier comes in. By raising my multiplier and adding a little bit of redshift, I can make my scene brighter and make it look like there's actual intense sunlight in the scene. So just play around with physical sun and sky because cool things happen regardless of what you do. Now, one more thing. Let's go into our render settings and go to the quality tab and just drag that slider way up. And when we do this, it's going to increase the overall quality in our scene. And we'll see that that gets rid of a lot of the noisiness that we see in parts of our render. All right, that's it for physical sun and sky. Now you probably get an idea of why I call it the Make Cool button. Basically, you turn it on and it makes your scene look better. Hopefully you found this video helpful. Click subscribe or give me a shout out in the comments if you did.